Welcome to the Refinery Primer website. If you're new to visual scripting and generative design, this is a great way to start to see the benefits of generative design inside of the design AEC world. There is an introduction site here just explaining what the primer is about. If you're wanting to get in and actually learn some of the tools, there's some excellent sample workflows here. You'll see there's getting started sample workflows for making forms and then optimizing and randomizing the forms. Some relevant ones here are some of the architectural workflows. There are three. There is a building mass generator. This allows you to add your levels and your floors and then randomize the layout of the floors, number of floors, so floor height, building height, the U values and V values. There's another one here for solar analysis, where you can start to do a deeper dive on how the lighting, the day lighting, the sun lighting is going around that building and how it's going to affect the facade. And finally here we have one which I'm going to show, which is called the office layout. So basically what you can do is you can download the workflow files. And it comes with the script, it comes with the Revit model, and it's ready to go. It tells you a bit about the variable inputs, the functions, the visualization they're going to get to see, and how it's evaluated, and then Refinery and how you run the results. So here inside of Revit 20, I have the Revit model. So just a core and a basic set of walls laid out. And I'm just going to open the script. So I've already downloaded this before, and I'm going to fire this one up. So it's just the Dynamo script here. To access Dynamo, if you haven't accessed it, you go to your Manage tab, and you'll fire up Dynamo. And here we have the script. Now, this one is a complex script. You don't need to know all of this, though. You can just go in to here and use some of the tools to do input for the workstation layouts and its constraints. So there's tools here for rotation, positioning on the surface, desktop width, etc. And when we drop down here, you can sort of see the maximum amount of steps you can choose from. So we've got a minimum of 3, maximum of 6 for the width of the desks, and so on. If you need to know more about what everything does, there's a bit more information here, which are color-coded in terms of the variables, the Revit output, the functions, the outputs, visualization, etc. And some other little things that you might need, like the version of Dynamo, any additional comments that you might need to get this up and running. So here, I'm just going to bring this up so you can see them both at the same time. And here we have the Revit model on the right and the Dynamo script. So I'm just going to hit run. You can actually have this run on manual and automatic. I'm just going to hit run. I just want to show you the results. And what this is going to do is it's going to go through the layout and add desks as required.